Well, guys, this is exactly what I didn't want to tell you about the SL20 version 2 after 100 miles. Let's check it out after a quick intro. Enjoy the video. Welcome back, guys, to another video. Today we are here in Santorini for my vacations, a beautiful island in Greece. If you are new, I'm Stelvio, and this is Koryamone, a community where you can find a lot of passionate runners, running trainings, gear reviews, and a lot of running motivation. Thanks to all of you who is already subscribed and supporting the channel, contributing with a lot of comments, interesting feedback. And for the other, please consider to subscribe. You will support the channel and you will be part of this community for free. Don't forget to activate the notification bell here below so you won't miss any new video. Before to start, just a quick disclosure, this is a pair of shoes that I bought with my money and no one is paying me for this review. If you missed the initial video review, you can find the link up here with all the specs of the shoe, where unfortunately I was somehow predicting what happened during these days. I ran several trainings with the SL20 version 2, like for all the other shoes under review. So running, tempo run, fartlek and other fast workouts, and I collected the running dynamic metrics during the first run and after 100 miles to compare the result and check the differences. If you are interested on the data, you can connect with me in Garmin Connect or in Strava, where I usually put all my training in. Don't forget to visit also my Instagram page, Koryamone, where you can find all my daily updates. You can find all the links in the description here below. As usual, I did a flag test that you can see here on the left hand side, and looking to the data, I observed that basically the ground contact time is slightly longer after 100 miles, and the shoe is less punchier than before because the vertical oscillation ratio has lower values at the same pace. So this means that the shoe is less responsive but with a lower vertical oscillation, which supports us to propel forward instead of vertically. Moreover, I measured again the stiffness of the foam, and the last strike started to be slightly softer already after a few miles, and the measurement with the durometer confirmed the impressions, because instead of having 44.5, I had measured 43.9 this time, which was definitely expected from my side. Outsole now. As already mentioned in the initial video review, the patterns used in the sole don't collect stones and ensures great traction and control thanks to the design but also to the continental rubber used. As you can see from the footage, the sole looks brand new, no signs of wear, even in the most common part of the sole. They use a great quality materials. And this result is even more noticeable because I really use the shoe in different conditions and kind of paths. The spotted foam is not that much, but you can see that it begins to wear out in the mid of the forefoot, where I'm used to land. So let's start to talk about the
midsole now.
In regard the midsole, as the data collected confirmed, the shoe is less bouncy than before and less responsive, with pretty normal differences on the values after 100 miles. The lifestyle foam, as you can see from the signs of wear, has become a bit softer in the entire midsole, and of course in general the shoe start to be more comfortable. The sports lifestyle foam in the forefoot seems to be even softer than expected, giving us a clear idea why the shoe is less responsive than before. If they would have used the torsion system, probably it would be helpful in this regard, keeping the shoe more responsive.
Upper now.
And now let's talk about the upper. Really well done, wrapping well the foot. It is not too tight in the forefoot, through two sides. It is breathable even during the warmer days like here in Santorini. Still, it has the same shape as before, and it looks brand new except for something I was predicting during my first impression review, but I didn't want to tell you for such a renewed shoe, especially because the rest of the shoe is okay. Unfortunately, during these days, with all the ups and downs here in Santorini, one of the ring for the lasers get broken, and luckily the video was not yet uploaded. This is really pity. And I believe that such kind of aesthetic details should be implemented in the sneakers only and not in running shoes such as the SL20. Adidas, please, if you're watching the video, remove those rings from the shoe, please. But this was not surprising me, so since the beginning that the rings could be a big disadvantage of this shoe. Regarding the color, I love this colorway because it doesn't get dirty soon, and the shoe looks still okay, not like the Adios 6 after 100 miles, which video review you can find in the link up here. As you can understand, for the lasers and the lockdown, I cannot confirm that they are working great, because now they are fully compromised thanks to this beautiful yellow ring. Crazy. As I said in the first video, it doesn't have a great rocker in the forefoot, so I would suggest different shoe for long tempo run. And I confirm I like more for fartlek. I would not use them in any race. I think them a good versatile daily trainer, but not for racing, because they are not that responsive, heavier than other racing shoes, and they don't support the rolling motion, which can help during racing. So in conclusion, it is clear that the shoe is not made for racing or for a long tempo run. Rather, it is better for fartlek or for slow recovery run. I mean, they can be used for tempo run, but I believe there are better options out there for this purpose, like for instance the Asics Evoride 2, which is still not expensive, and which video review you can find up here. For the fartlek, during the slow repeats, the wide heel area gave me a big support in terms of stability, especially at the end of the training, which didn't force me to land in the mid of the foot, even when you are super tired, like for instance the Adios 6. I confirm I prefer the previous version, first of all because it has no hugging nylon rings, which get broken easily. It is lighter, it has a torsion system which support and keep the shoe responsive even after 100 miles, and overall it has an even better aesthetic in my opinion. So Adidas, please, for the next model, throw away those horrible nylon rings and put in the torsion system, please. That's it for my another my review, guys. I hope you like it. Please leave a like and consider to subscribe to the channel. As usual, thanks for your support and for watching the video, and I'll see you soon in the next one. Ciao. Oh guys, this is exactly what I didn't want to tell you about the SL20 version 2 after 100 miles.